$100. Oh, that's what I have. Man, I'm a rich man. Talking about rich man, so something comes to my mind. You know what? Rich man's disease. Oh, wow. You know what that is? The rich man's disease. Let me tell you this story, then you can get the idea. Long time ago, only rich people got this disease, okay? So that means that time, only rich people had a lot of meat, okay? So which is heavy protein. So now, if you take excessive protein, then end product of any protein, so which is amino acids. That's what uric acid. Oh. So uric acid is actually crystal. So this is going to be deposited in our body, especially joint, okay, like ankle or knees and wrist or someplace like that. Okay, then we get pain. Oh, that's why a lot of people who has that disease, then they have a heavy pain. Especially ankle area, okay, it's going to getting bigger, okay, so which is, oh, that's right, swollen with a lot of pain. But long time ago, only rich people had that disease. That's why they called the rich man's disease. That's the nickname now. So now, actual name for that one. So you got the idea, right? Ah, man. That's it. Gout. Which is G-O-U-T. That's it. Gout. Actually, a few days ago, so one of my high school students asked me very interesting question. Just like this. Okay, one day, okay, Mr. Bill Gates, the richest man in the world, right? So he walked on the street. Then all of a sudden, he dropped $100 bill. Then the question is, he has to pick it up or just walk away? I was not sure because maybe he takes what? How much time? Oh, maybe 1 second or 2 seconds. Okay, so, oh, he's 1 second worth more than $100 or less than $100? Depends on that, right? So I told him that, hey, let me figure it out later. Anyway, the most important thing is my $100. That's it. Okay, I'm gonna deposit this one in the bank, okay? But my question was, what bank? You know, some bank, they're gonna give me, yeah, 8% APR. You know what APR stands for, right? So APR, which is annual percentage rate. That's it. Which is, like somebody said, 8%. Okay, some bank, they say, oh, 5%. Some bank, maybe 3%. Things like that. Oh, you know what? Okay, one bank, they said, oh, we're going to give you 100%. Whoa, man, that was it. 100%. Unbelievable. I couldn't trust this guy. So, you know what? I decide, oh, let me try just $1. Now, I was so excited. And, oh, it was January 1st. Anyway, this original money we call principal, right? Oh, that's it. Principal. Just like this. Then, oh, yeah, I was figuring out how much dollar gonna be end of this year. Oh, man, I was waiting for 1 year because this was annual percentage rate, right? But long time ago, I was learning this one. Oh, principal money times 1 plus, oh, that's right, RT. Oh, that's right. That's a simple interest, right? Okay, actually, total money I'm talking about. The inside of this one, so RT, that's interest. Okay, this one was a total money, sum. Okay, let me figure this one out now. Principal, 1 times 1 plus the rate 100%. Oh, I know how to write this one just like this. 100 per and cent times time. Time was one year. That's it. Now I can calculate this one. 100 divided by 100 is 1. 1 times 1 is 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. 2 times 1. Whoa, man. This is going to be $2. That's it. But something happened in December. So one day in December, I need that money really bad. So I went to the bank. I said, I need that money. Then, oh, that's it. Then they gave me $1 back. Because this was an APR, also that APR, okay, so compounded how many times? Okay, that's one time. I didn't know that. Okay, so they said, oh, that's it. You're going to wait 1 year. That's it, exactly. Because they do compound only once. Oh, man. So I asked them, at least half maybe? Oh, no way. So I asked them again. So they gave me idea. How about every 6 months? Okay, that means twice a year, they're going to compound my money. That means within 6 months, I go there, I get, after 6 months anyway. So after 6 months, okay, then I get that money back. Then at least they give me half, okay? Which is, then I get $1.50, right? Then let me figure this one out. Okay, total money is a different now. Okay, principal, which is $1 anyway. Okay, so I can ignore that. Okay, now, 1 plus. That's right. The rate, because of twice a year, that means they said, oh, every half year, they can give me 50%. Oh, that's it. 50% right there. Then, one more time, exactly the same thing, just like this one, right? That means this is going to be squared. That's it. Okay, from now on, so I'm going to ignore this P because P is $1 anyway. So now, 1 plus, oh, 50%, which is 0.5, right? That means totally 1.5 squared. That means 1.5 times 1.5, which is 2.25, right? Ooh, very interesting. Okay, 2.25. Lot better than $2, right? Because, oh, I get 25 cents more, see? Now I got the better idea, so total, so now 1 plus, what about 4 times? Every quarter, I'm going to get compound, okay? So then, oh, wait a minute, that means every quarter, that means 25%. Oh, that's it, 25%. Then we're going to have 4 times of this one, right? 4 compounded. Okay, that means this is going to be 4th power. That's it. So this is going to be 2.44 something, just about 2.44, which is $2.44. Lot better than 25 cents, right? Then I went back to the bank. I asked them, hey, how about every month? Oh, then they said, oh man, all right, we'll do it for you. Okay, then every 12. Okay, let me try easy number first. Okay, instead of 12, I'm going to use 10. Easy to calculate, right? That means 100% divided by 10, which is 10%, right? Which is 1/10. That's it. Okay, 1 divided by 10. That's it. Then we're going to have this parenthesis 10 times. That means 10th power. That's it. Which is 1.1. to the 10th power. This was 2.5937. Okay, 2.59. Okay, keep on going. Okay, 37, so which is 4. Okay. Finally, I asked him, so this one getting better and better. So I asked him, oh, how about 100 times? Then you know what he said? You know what? Okay, you look good. I'm going to give you forever, okay, so infinite multiplication, which is compound, okay. That means, oh, 1 divided by infinite. Oh, infinite looks like this one, right? Very, very big number, huge number right here. That means we got to use what? Huge number of exponent right there. That's it. Now I remember this one. Oh man, that's a famous number. You know what? Okay, that's right. 2.71828. Oh, it goes forever, which is an irrational number. This is what the famous symbol small e. That's it. Oh man. Okay, after elementary school. So you know what this one is, right? Pi. Pi is 3.14, right? Oh, that's it. What about square root of 2? That's it. So 1.4142, right? See, we're gonna remember so many numbers. Your brain's gonna be better and better, twinkle, twinkle every day. After middle school or high school, that's right. This E, you must remember this one. Let's go. 2.71828, that's it. Actually, every calculator, they have this sign, okay, E. You punch it, okay, check it out.